I feel sweaty. I am sweat, and this is what we do. Hello, universe. My name is the great Sony Baloney, and today we're going to be talking about insane music careers. Now, some of you may or may not know that the infamous Dwayne The Rock Johnson has a music career, has been featured in a Tech N9ne song where he has a fire verse. I actually have never listened to it, and we're going to listen to it right now. Where is this in context to the song? I'm confused. Is that the end? Yeah. Oh, it's trending 11 on music. Damn. All right. I don't want to get demonetized or whatever. DMCA'd. Sweaty. Nah, I can't consider myself a fan of music, the musical likings, and this shit, pretty fire. I'll say it. Fuck it. The Rock obviously got this because of his song in Moana. I mean, I will say this. Nothing can beat the Moana flow. I will say that. Nothing will beat You're Welcome. It's a bop. Nothing will come close. This is what happens when you get a top hit like this. You can pretty much go wherever you want. Honestly, after this. I'm surprised Lil Uzi Vert hasn't asked The Rock to be a feature. I thought that was really surprising, so it made me look up who else released songs. And I found this BuzzFeed article, and I thought that was fun. But, I mean, a lot of them I already heard about before. I didn't know that Bruce Willis released an entire album. But I think the most interesting one that I found, I mean, this guy's Wallows. We all know that. Was fucking Draco Malfoy. Draco Malfoy has a single, at least. You got anything new? 10 years ago, 12 years ago, 13 years ago. Felt Beats. Disappointing that it doesn't have anything out right now. Also, I found out that Scarlett Johansson has an album. Let's listen to that. This is boring. I'm bored. Scarlett Johansson makes a mid music. Tom Felton, I would listen to it. I listened to it maybe. Because the wind has crossed it over and I still can't see. Nah, I take it back. His stuff is cringe. And a lot of this stuff is gonna be pretty cringe, honestly. Cause like, come on. It's celebrities making music. They're good at one thing and one thing only, you know? But someone that was not on this list, someone who I thought couldn't get any better, someone who's work, art, movies transcend society, transcend us as a human race. I am talking, of course, about legendary actor Vin Diesel. I can't. It's so funny. You think to yourself, like, a couple of these people, you're like, all right, what are they gonna sound like? It's kind of interesting to see what their music is gonna really sound like. This literally just sounds like somebody recorded Vin Diesel's voice and just put it over chill hop beats, you know? The drop! Fuck yeah! And he has another single too. This is not the only one. This one is the one I heard. I remember not too long ago. We were counting stars and oh. The summer nights never turning cold. The season came and went like snow. It's a bop. Let's see what kind of comments are turned off. Why? Why? What did you do to this poor man? What the fuck? Is it turned off on his other one too? What the fuck? Is it that bad? Holy shit, dude. Oh my god, what? This is in 2013. I need more. I need more of this. I need this injected straight into my fucking veins. So these are videos that he posts to his Facebook? So like, he's got one of Rihanna. This is actually nice, I will say. I would have liked it if like he had a better like mix. If it's not just him literally in an empty room in his fucking mansion with a projector. You couldn't find the karaoke version of this? I'm a dealer in the bathtub, then I go to sex clubs, then I just freaking people get along. The dude doesn't know the song. He doesn't know the words. It's so deep. Oh boy. I love this. I love this. I love this because I feel like he's doing the thing that like a lot of kids do where it's like, I really like this song and I can sing it. And then I don't know, maybe his wife or girlfriend or something, maybe his roommate. I don't know. Somebody just like, yeah, it's great. And he's like, let me film. What if I just put the music on and I sang over it? That'd be cool, right? He heard it once and he's like, man, I could sing this. I could sing this really good. And he's got the melody and stuff, but he doesn't know the word. I want to be just that rich so I could just be like, yeah, I'll do whatever I want. I don't even care. I don't care if it sucks. Vin Diesel had a break dance. I want to see Vin Diesel crunk. Ooh. Ooh. Vin Diesel, everybody. Nice. I would have liked to see Vin Diesel do the worm, though. Wait for it. Wait for it. Oh, reverse worm. Oh, my God. This is better than I could have asked for. Holy shit, that's funny. I have to see that again. Reverse worm by Vin Diesel. Is that a real move? Oh my god. Holy shit. Holy shit, dude. There's no way. Holy fuck. They gave him a choice. The fame or the hair. There has to be more. I need more. Vin Diesel's so incredible, dude. I don't know if a lot of people know about Vin Diesel. I knew from an article that I read somewhere that Vin Diesel was or is or has wrote a movie about his own D&D character. And I want to know more about it. Let me show you what I got here. If you want to blow someone's mind, when the subject of Vin Diesel comes up in conversation, there are two facts you might want to mention. One, he and Paul Giamatti are the same age by a matter of weeks. Okay, why? He's a massive nerd, is more fitting. No, I never played D&D. For some reason, they thought I played D&D for 20 years. They thought I spent years playing Barbarians, Witch Hunters, the Arcanium. They thought I played D&D back in the 70s when it was just the basic D&D set. They thought I continued to play D&D when it became Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. They thought I played D&D when there were only three books, the Player's Handbook, the Monster's Manual, and the Dungeon Master's Guide. They thought I played D&D as it continued on to the Unearthed Arcanium, Oriental Adventures, Sea Adventures, Wilderness Adventures. They thought I played D&D at the time when the Deities and Demigods was brand new book. Yeah. He's hilarious. That's hilarious. He loves D&D, dude. At least he's trying something different. I think we need to hear this one more time.
I remember not
Nailed it.